Yes.
It's been a long time, long time since I left you, without a dope beat.
It's still.
But you can't be any geek off the street. You gotta be handy with the steel if you know what I mean.
Keeping it real.
Hello and welcome to the channel. My name is Steven and this is Steel Keeping It Real. So you know what today is.
Looking good, Billy Ray!
That's right, it is Yacht Rock Wednesday. And on this day, I'd like to play adult contemporary hits from the 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, 2000s. But they are normally of a Caucasian persuasion. And in this particular video, I don't think you could get more Caucasian than Elton John. Now, I'm not saying anything about Elton John. I love me some Elton John. I love me some Elton John before he did Disney songs. After Disney songs, you know, that's Elton, you know, making money for his retirement. But beforehand, and especially in the 70s, he was free. He was just making music, him and Bernie Taupin, and they were some of the greatest songs that were ever created. So this one is coming out of 1983. You know, I had a lot of Elton John songs that I could have done, but I chose this one because it was the one that had a video, the one that didn't get blocked when I tried to see if this is a video that I could play, and the one that kind of reminded me just by the video of being on the beach or being on a boat or something like that. The sun is shining, everything like that. You know, I could hear this playing on a yacht in the background because it's just one of those songs where it makes you feel good. And I also wanted to bring out the fact that the judge, Bruno Tonioli, from Dancing with the Stars, his big claim to fame, even though he's a choreographer and everything else like that, is the fact that he was in this video a lot. So, you know, I didn't know that at the time, that I knew who, I had seen Bruno Tonioli way back in 1983 when this video came out. When I was watching Dance with the Stars later on, I was like, oh, snap. Oh, it is that dude. Hey, it is. And so that's kind of cool that he has that, especially as that early in his resume. So good on you. So if you like videos like this and others on the channel, please don't forget to hit the like button, the subscribe button, and the notification button, because I'm doing at least 15 videos each and every week. Now, we also have to talk about this on the charts. So this song went to number 3 in Australia, 11 in Belgium, 1 in Canada, top singles, number 10 in Germany, number 2 in Ireland, number 16 in the Netherlands single, top 100, and number 8 on the Netherlands Dutch top 40, number 30 in New Zealand, 9 in South Africa, number 1 in Switzerland, number 4 in his native UK, number 12 on the US Hot Billboard Hot 100, number 28 on the US Adult Contemporary, number 34 on the US Mainstream Rock, and number 18 on the US Cash Rock Top 100. And for some reason, it went into number 50 in 2019 in Poland, Polish Airplay Top 100. I don't know what happened in 2019 that Poland all of a sudden wanted to start playing I'm Still Standing. I mean, they were already a free country way back in like the 80s with Lech Walesa or whatever his name was. So I'm wondering why they were playing I'm Still Standing or really into Elton John at that time. So without any further ado, here is Elton John and I'm Still Standing.
Here we go.
You can never know what it's like. Your blood like winter
the lonely light that shines from you. You'll wind up like the wreck you hide behind that mask you use. And did you think this fool could never win? Well, look at me, I'm coming back again. I got a taste of love in a simple way. And if you need to know while I'm still standing, you just fade away. Don't you know I'm still standing better than I ever did? Looking like a true survivor, feeling like a little kid. And I'm still standing after all this time, picking up the pieces of my life without you on my mind. I'm still standing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I'm still standing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Once I never could have hoped to win, you're stopping down the road leaving me again. You made were meant to cut me down. And if my love was just a circus, you'd be a clown by now. No, I'm still standing better than I ever did. Looking like a true survivor, feeling like a little kid. I'm still standing after all this time, picking up the pieces.
Like really one of the first videos that allowed Elton John to let his freak flag fly to a certain extent. If you didn't know anything about Elton John by then you were living under a rock because basically he showed himself. You know, if you had seen him in concert and seen other things, you knew how eccentric he could be. You know, how flamboyant that he kind of was at a certain part of his life. But by the time 83 rolled around, he wasn't hiding it anymore, which is fine. That never bothered me at all. It didn't hinder the songs that my mother had, you know, nursed me with at an early age when I'm listening to things like Your Song and Candle in the Wind before they sold it out. And whenever anybody dies now, it's like, goodbye, Coolio. I'm sorry, too soon. I'm not surprised. Nobody hasn't done that. But you know, that song, you know, Funeral for a Friend, Love Lies Bleeding, you know, it's just some of it, you know, Goodbye Yellow Brick Road, you know, Daniel, all of these great songs, you know, that he had, you know, even before all of a sudden it's like, oh, so he's gay. Okay. It just really didn't matter to me, you know. I never, you know, even into the late 80s, that never bothered me because I wasn't raised that way. I wasn't raised to be discriminating against anybody, whether it be their race or whether it be their sexual orientation or anything like that. So it wasn't a big deal to me. I'm sure it was a big deal to him because it was finally a time when he could, live his, true self. But, and I only say that because it's his story. At the time, it was his story to tell. Nobody else is saying, hey, I know this about... You know what? If somebody wants to come out, they come out. If they don't, they don't. Nobody should be forced to do it. You're not being treated. You know what? It's for some, I know about back in the day, it's a big deal to do that. I've had friends that, when I remember one friend, and I'm not going to name names because I don't know, how they are right now, but I remember one friend, very confidently telling me that they were gay, and it's like, you know what? I think I knew. I think that's what I said. It's like, I think I already knew that. It was no big deal. So that was, that's the way we handled things in the 80s. The 80s were, I'm going to say this, if I say it 1,000 times, the 80s was the generation, and the teenagers of the 80s were like leftovers from the 70s. The 70s kids wanted to believe in peace and love and happiness, and then the 80s just took that into we're gonna be great to each other, we're gonna help each other regardless of who was our president at the time, we're gonna do all these generous and generous things and helping people out and making sure, that, no apartheid and all that other kind of stuff. We're going to hit it head on. And, that's 80s kids. People starving in Africa, that's 80s kids. Mive Aid and USA for Africa, all those things. That's what 80s kids were about. And then, all of a sudden communism is, in Europe, with the Berlin Wall coming down, what was it, 1990? I can't remember. Mr. Gorbachev, Reagan was still president. Mr. Gorbachev, tore down that wall. So all these things were great about the 80s, and the 80s were just so colorful. People look back and they want to make fun of 80s fashion and hair and everything else like that. But, when you're in it, it's not fun. It's not funny. It's a lot of identity crisis is going on in the 80s of people trying to find out who they are and what they are. Fat Times at Richmond High, where all these girls were like doing their hair and their fashion like Pat Benatar. And then you also had all those girls that when Madonna came out, they wanted to dress like Madonna because they really didn't have an identity, and that was one of the things that the 80s allowed to have a lot of creativity and colors and things like that. Dudes were trying to dress like Duran Duran or punk rockers or shaving their heads because they were skinheads or having a mohawk or, everybody had their sleeves rolled up like this all the time for no apparent reason. Like you were going to do some work, but you just forgot what that work was supposed to be. I never had a sports coat with the rolled up sleeves, but Michael J. Fox rocked it like crazy.
Yo, the sign is real simple, B. It says wrap it up. Wrap that shit up, B.
I'm rambling. If you are still here, I thank you very much. I could talk about the 80s forever. If you are still here, I thank you very much for staying tuned. I really do appreciate it. First and foremost, I want you guys to like the videos as much as I like making them for you. After that, all you need to do to help me out with my channel is to like, subscribe, share, and comment. Peace.